So as we reach the latest episode of this Ben Simmons saga, this entire situation is now officially longer than the Frieza saga and Dragon Ball Z. Nothing has really moved on any front, and it was pretty clear from Sixers Media Day yesterday that President of Basketball Operations Daryl Morey is gonna call Simmons bluff. He basically said it yesterday in his quote about, you know, potentially fining Simmons, saying that it's spelled out in his contract and the CBA. So nothing's really changed on that front. His teammates have basically said they've tried to talk to him, specifically Joel Embiid and Tobias Harris, and nothing has really changed from Simmons' stance on wanting to leave Philadelphia and never wanting to wear a Sixer jersey again. The reason I am recording this video today is to address a new report from The Athletic that came out. And look, it's not a report that changes anything. And we have spent basically since the end of the Sixers-Hawks series, we have plowed the ground over 5,500 times on the Ben Simmons situation and, you know, releasing all the Ben Simmons content we can consume. But it's this report right here that has me sort of annoyed. Well, not really sort of annoyed. I'm actually really annoyed at this report from The Athletic, Sam Amick. Basically, Ben Simmons has, to quote part of the article, Ben Simmons has concluded that he is done playing with Joel Embiid. While it's not personal, Simmons believes that playing around Embiid's style isn't conducive to the way he needs to play. And I have a lot of problems with this article, because if you actually read the article just beyond the tweet, it is a paywall, so you do have to pay. You have to pay whatever it is monthly. The Athletic has all kinds of promotions and all that stuff, so I don't know what the exact price is. It's good journalism. Pay for good content. Anyway, if you go beyond and actually read the article, a lot of Simmons' reasonings are absurd. And it sounds like a lot of the other reasonings that were previously reported weren't really his actual reasons. And it's tough to go off of this because Simmons himself hasn't said anything, but he's not going to say anything. And there's well-plugged-in reporters that have reported a lot of this stuff over the summer, and it's now just coming to the forefront over the last few weeks. But we seem to have the actual reasons here in this Sam Amick article, who is also well plugged into the NBA. And need I remind you that The Athletic also has Shams Charania on the team, who is now under the agency of Clutch Sports, which is the same agency as Ben Simmons. First of all, let's address what the article starts off with, which is the potential Ben Simmons and James Harden trade that apparently fell through for whatever reason, whether Daryl Morey didn't want to include a young guy into the trade, whether he didn't want to, the reports were he didn't want to include Maxey in the deal or whatever, which I find that hard to believe, because Daryl's whole ethos in his entire career as an executive is to get stars no matter what the cost is. So I find that hard to believe. I more lean towards believing the reports that Tillman Fertitta, the owner of the Houston Rockets, didn't want to do business with his former GM, who told him that he was going to step away, but then literally a month later turns around and decides to become the head of basketball operations for the Philadelphia 76ers. I lean more towards believing that report, but apparently the Ben Simmons, James Harden potential trade was the first signs of real fracture within the franchise, and really that whole reasoning is absurd. Look, players deserve to feel a certain type of way if they're on the trade market and things of that nature, but as Embiid said in yesterday's press conference, like, you need to look at yourself. Like, do you really think that you yourself wouldn't trade yourself for James Harden? Like, James Harden is an MVP caliber player, to that point had led the Rockets to two Western Conference Finals, made it to an NBA Finals as a crucial sixth man for the Oklahoma City Thunder. You really think you wouldn't trade yourself for James Harden? And that's why you're mad at the 76ers? Really? This next point in the article, which is what I mentioned earlier, it's that Ben Simmons is apparently done playing with Joel Embiid. And just to take a quote from this article, as he sees it, sources say, the organization's choice to build its basketball ecosystem around Embiid's style of play isn't simply conducive to the way he needs to play. So while Embiid insisted to reporters on Monday that he wants Simmons back, this much is clear: the feeling is not mutual. It has run its course, the source said of their pairing. I'm trying to comprehend what these reasonings even mean, because really, 90% of this entire situation could have been avoided if Simmons had just improved even a little bit on the offensive end of the floor since coming into the league as a rookie. Because I've seen people try to say, oh, it's the Sixers' fault too, it's 50-50. It's not 50-50. A lot of this could have been avoided if Ben Simmons had just held up his end of the bargain and actually improved on the offensive end. The Sixers have done everything for Ben Simmons. They have tried to get guards and shooters around Simmons and Embiid. They tried to get a stretch five for Ben Simmons, so when Embiid goes to the bench, he can actually have a center that allows Ben to flourish more in the style of play he wants to. But even then, Ben Simmons last year played in a starting lineup with everybody in the lineup shooting above average from three. Joel Embiid has adjusted his game every single year of his career to accommodate the fact that Ben Simmons not only won't shoot, but he refuses to shoot, he can't shoot, and not only that, all of a sudden, he refuses to attack the rim in the Hawks series. It really sounds like this entire time, Simmons is putting everybody else to blame except for himself, instead of looking at himself in the mirror. And it's disappointing because he has all the potential in the world. He's 6'10", super fast, has handle, can pass, is an all-world defensive player of the year caliber type of defender. And yet, it's everybody else's fault? Like, I'm sorry. If you felt a type of way that you were on the trading block for James fucking Harden, then maybe you should have improved your offensive game to the point to where the Sixers could be like, hey, look, we have a 24-year-old, 25-year-old star that's on the upswing that is clearly on an MVP trajectory path. We're kind of uneasy about putting Ben Simmons in a James Harden trade. Just think of it this way. Last year, if the Celtics were in the situation the Sixers were in, and the only way to get James Harden was to put Jason Tatum in the trade, you think Celtics fans want to do that? No, because they have a cost-controlled young player who is 23 years old and who is clearly on a path to be one of the best players in the NBA, is already bordering on a tier one franchise level type of player. Ben Simmons isn't that, and he could have been that if he actually decided to improve from the jump. But no, he decided, and this is another report from Yaron Weitzman, who wrote Tanking to the Top, which is about, obviously, the process and the Sam Hinkie era. He reported over the summer after the Sixers-Hawks series was over that Ben Simmons, going into his sophomore year after he broke his foot his rookie year and had to miss the whole rookie year, but in Ben Simmons' quote-unquote rookie year, he ditched the 76ers shooting coach that was hired by Brett Brown, who was a renowned shooting coach, decided to ditch him and hire his brother, his half-brother, to be the shooting coach when he has no experience working with professional players and has really his highest basketball experience was, I believe, D2 college. Ben Simmons had every opportunity to make the situation better for himself. But instead, everybody in the Sixers organization tried to capitulate to adjust to Simmons, who had no interest in shooting. The Sixers have literally done everything. They've tried, they even gave Al Horford a terrible fucking contract just so Al Horford can essentially play backup center when Simmons is on the floor and Embiid is off the floor. And because of that contract, Embiid's spacing was cramped. It affected Embiid. He had a down year that year. Everybody started questioning Embiid. Is he out of shape? Is he this? Is he that? What's wrong with Joel Embiid? No, the Sixers were trying to build a team to adjust to Simmons' strengths because Simmons refuses to address his weaknesses. And that is the main issue. If he had been interested in actually shooting the basketball, improving with his left hand, finishing around the rim, and getting to the free throw line, and adjusting his aggressive mindset, because there were times when Ben was aggressive, he would average like 28-8. You would see the potential. There would be these last two seasons, there were easily 1.5, 2 month stretches where Ben Simmons was flat out one of the best players in the NBA because he would attack the rim relentlessly, free throws be damned. But obviously, that comes and goes. It's not consistent enough. He doesn't want to adjust his mindset. He doesn't want to shoot during the games, even though he posts videos every fucking summer of him working on his jump shot and working on his game. He doesn't translate that to the actual games. But it's Joel Embiid's fault. It's the Sixers' fault for wanting to build an ecosystem around a player that is clearly better than you. Once the Markelle Fultz injury happened, Ben Simmons wanted to be the point guard. And any time the Sixers tried to make an adjustment that strayed away from Ben Simmons being the point guard, such as putting Ben Simmons at the four, making him more of a screen and roll guy, and all this other stuff, Ben Simmons would bristle at that because he wanted to be the point guard. You wanted the max extension. And when teams give you the max extension, paying you like you are the second cornerstone of the franchise, there is an expectation that maybe you want to expand your offensive game a little bit and help out your other co-star, as opposed to it being a one-way street to where Embiid is shooting threes, doing everything he can in his game to adjust to your playing style because he wants this thing to work. We don't have to talk about their relationship or whatever it is over their entire era together, but Embiid clearly wanted to make this work. He wants to win a championship for the city of Philadelphia. But it's Embiid's fault. Embiid's style isn't conducive to you. There are only so many centers in the NBA that are exclusively stretch bigs and won't clog up the paint. But even if you do play with that ideal center, are you going to change your mindset and actually attack the basket all the time? Are you actually going to finish with your left hand? It still looks like a bowling ball every time it leaves your hands. Players can request trades. They can ask for a change of scenery. I'm all for players doing whatever they can to better their careers. But rarely have I seen... Actually, I don't remember a time in recent history where a player with 4 years left on his deal asks out of a team that is clearly a contender. We can argue about where they would be in the Milwaukee-Brooklyn tier. I would have Milwaukee and Brooklyn, just objectively speaking, over the Sixers. But they're clearly a contender that can win a lot of regular season games when you're out there. You say you want to win championships, yet your starting lineup was the best it's ever been around you. Why is it exactly everybody else's fault but Ben Simmons? That's my only question.